Hello, GCC. We are plugging along in Chapter 5 still. It's a long chapter, but we're almost finished. We're going to talk now about ion formation. So what is an ion? An ion is an atom that has gained or lost some of its outer valence electrons. Now, why would they do that? So why do atoms make compounds with other atoms? Why do they bond with other atoms? What's the motivation behind that? So the only atoms that don't do that are the noble gases. The noble gases don't make compounds or bond, but all the other atoms do. They all find partners and friends and buddy up and make compounds. So what's so special about the noble gases? Well, the atoms want to be like the noble gases because they're so stable and happy with that S2P6 outer configuration, 8 valence electrons. This makes them happy and stable. So all the other atoms want to be like that. They want to be S2P6 also, except hydrogen wants to be like helium, which is just 1S2. Remember, helium is the exception of column 8. It only has 2 electrons, so 2 valence electrons. And hydrogen wants to be like helium sometimes. So most of the time, the atoms want to have 8 valence electrons. This is called the octet rule for 8. So the other atoms can gain electrons or lose electrons and be like a noble gas. They don't turn into a noble gas, of course. But they become ions because they no longer have equal protons and electrons because they either gain some electrons or they lose some electrons. So they become ions. An ion has the same number of protons as the atom it was. Protons does not change. But the number of electrons can increase or decrease. So there's a charge now. So an atom with a charge is an ion. An atom with a charge is an ion. And ions tend to be happy and stable. Let's look at sodium, for example. Sodium is in the first column. So sodium has 1 valence electron. Sodium is number 11. So sodium has 11 protons and 11 electrons. It's an atom. The configuration for sodium is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s1. Again, the outer level is the third level, and there's just that one little s electron out in the third level. So we want to lose that valence electron. We want it to go away. So it's going to lose that electron, and then it will be 11 protons, but 10 electrons. The electrons go down one. It loses an electron. So instead of 11, it has 10. So let's look at the electron configuration now for the ion. It's 1s1, 2s2, 2p6. Aha! It ends s2p6. Ding, 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 ding. That's what makes us happy and stable. Now, because it lost an electron, the charge is now sodium plus 1. Remember, electrons are negative. So if you lose a negative electron, you become more positive. That makes sense, right? If you lose negativity, you become a more positive person. Same thing with an atom. If it loses a negative electron, it becomes positive. Now, if it loses 1 electron, it's plus 1. If it loses 2 electrons, it becomes plus 2, and so forth. So sodium lost 1 electron. It went away. So sodium is now plus 1 charged. And because it has a charge, it's an ion. Now I want you to think about sulfur. Sulfur is way over here. It's number 16. Now sulfur is actually going to gain 2 electrons. Gain 2 electrons. So I want you to think about that. Write the configuration for sodium as an atom. And then write the electron configuration for for sulfur, for sulfur as an atom, and then write the configuration for sulfur when it's gained 2 electrons and see what it's like. Okay, and by like, I mean same electron configuration. Going back up to sodium plus, I need to point out 1s2, 2s2, 2p6 is sodium plus 1 charged. That is the same as neon. Neon has 10 electrons as well. So sodium plus 1 ion is like neon in that they have 10 electrons, so they have the same electron configuration. 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. So they are like. Did sodium turn into a neon? No, it's still sodium, but it's an ion now. So you're doing the same thing now with sulfur. So hit pause and look, check out sulfur. And we're back. So let's look. Sulfur has 16 protons and 16 electrons as an atom. The electron configuration for the atom is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p4. That's not stable and happy, is it? No. So sulfur is going to gain 2 electrons to bump that 4 up to 6. So when it does that, it gains 2 negative electrons that it didn't have before. So when you gain negativity, you become negative. Sulfur gained 2 negative electrons, so it has a minus 2 charge, or 2 minus, same thing. So sulfur 2 minus ion still has 16 protons. Protons don't change. But now it has 2 more electrons that it gained, so it went from 16 up to 18 electrons. It has 18 electrons. It has a charge, so it's an ion. The electron configuration for S2 minus is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6. Look at that. Ding, 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 ding. S2p6. That's how we end. That makes us happy and stable. So why is S2 minus like argon? Well, how many electrons does argon have? Argon has 18 electrons, just like sulfur 2 minus ion does. So they are alike. They have the same number of electrons and the same electron configuration. So you figure out the configuration for an ion by figuring out how many electrons it's gained or lost. So I want you to write the electron configurations for potassium plus 1, nitrogen minus 3, 3 minus, same thing. Magnesium plus 2, 2 plus, same thing. Those 3 ions, write the electron configurations for those. Hit pause, work on this. Again, this is your lecture. It's time to work. And then we'll come back. And we're back. All right, potassium is number 19. So the atom has 19 electrons and protons. Now, what does the plus 1 mean? Does that mean we gained a negative electron? Or did a negative electron go away? Means it went away. So we lost an electron. So instead of having 19 electrons, we now have 18 like argon. So the configuration is the same as argon's. 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6. See, we ended s2p6, 2 plus 6 is 8, 8 octet rule. Happy, happy. All right, let's try nitrogen 3 minus. Nitrogen is number 7. So 7 protons, 7 electrons for the atom. The 3 minus, did we gain 3 negative electrons? Or did 3 negative electrons go away if we're minus 3 charged? Means we gained 3 electrons, right? We have 3 more electrons than we started with. So we had 7 electrons. We gained 3. We now have 10 electrons, like neon. So 10 electrons is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. Again, we end s2p6. Happy, happy, happy. All right, last one, magnesium 2+. Magnesium is number 12. So 12 protons and 12 electrons. But we have a 2+ charge. Does that mean we gained 2 negative electrons? Or did 2 negative electrons go away? Yeah, they went away. So magnesium became more positive, positive 2 charge. So magnesium was 12 electrons, but it lost 2, makes it 10, like neon. So again, the electron configuration is for 10 electrons, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. And there are the answers. You can pause and write those down in your notes. I hope you're taking some notes. So that's how we figure out electron configurations for ions, which means the atom has a charge. And that's a great place to pause. So let's take a break here again, and we'll come back for our last Chapter 5 video.